It's time for the Summer Games review you've all been waiting for. It's time for the Overwatch Summer Games 2016! Whoops, wrong Summer Games. It's time for the Roblox Summer Games 2016. The result of Roblox thinking it was a good idea to make a sequel to an event from 2 years ago that received very negative reviews. Looking back though, I think I was a bit too harsh towards the 2014 Summer Games, because compared to this, it's a masterpiece. Now that I think about it, maybe reviewing Overwatch's Summer Games would have been more fun than this. Summer Games 2016 is yet another bland reskin of the same event we've been getting non-stop for the past 2 years. 3 games selected at random with 2 prizes each for completing mundane tasks. There's barely anything new to talk about here, and as an event reviewer, this is the bane of my existence. I thought that Summer Camp 2016 might have been the start of a new generation for events. We could have the same 3 games concept while still having one game specifically made for the event. It was the perfect idea, but apparently not perfect enough for them, because we got this again instead. I guess that's why I deserve for having faith in a Roblox event. Let's not forget the core purpose of this event though, the advertising. Let's see what obscure, weird, or just downright awful thing they've decided to force upon us this time. Okay? Never heard of that one either, but enjoy the ad revenue, I guess. Let's just get this over with. Surprisingly enough, they actually picked a pretty decent game for this event. I wouldn't get used to it, though. To get the prizes in this game, you have to kill 5 people in a single round and win 5 rounds on the red team. Or, in more simple terms, play the game like you normally would until you eventually get the prizes. Look, I get that these events are geared towards small children, but wouldn't it have been nice to have a bit of a challenge? Maybe? You're going to see this as a common theme throughout the whole event. This game gets a little bit of a pass for actually being a pretty fun game, but that doesn't excuse them from actually trying to spice it up a little bit. There's not even any sort of brand new special thing you have to do to get these prizes. Maybe a summer-themed boss fight? Nah man, that'd take way too much effort. Just throw in some random things a player could do naturally, and boom! Here's your game. It's not like the prizes are much better either. You could get a headdress and a gold medal. Nothing special here. I really wish there was more I could say about it, but that's all there is to it. I told you guys not to get used to there being good games here. Next up we've got a mediocre soccer game, or football, depending on where you live. I'll give this in Dodgeball some points though, at least they actually fit in with the theme of a summer competition. Other than that though, it's the same thing as last time. Think of a couple things you can naturally earn over time and boom, you got yourself another game for another effortless event. Now, let's play a game of difficulty roulette. How easy do you think these prizes will be? Ooh, looks like we're going to have even more unbelievably easy prizes. To get your first prize, you have to score a singular goal. That's right, 1. To get your second prize, you have to win 3 games of the new stadium. How fascinating. Here's what might have happened when they came up with this.
Hello, Builder Man. Guess what? What? This gag is getting old. Wow, I agree.
Well then, remember how I gave Dodgeball and Kickoff bonus points for actually fitting in with the theme of this event? This game just throws that right out the window, which is a shame because this whole event could have gotten a bonus point for having a good game selection. Instead, I'll have to give it half of a bonus point. Anyway, onto the game itself. It's a cheap town role-playing game that's identical to the millions of other awful town role-playing games out there. To get the prizes here, you have to find 3 clues pointing towards a dragon's existence. And drumroll, please! Light a torch. Except first you have to talk to a man in a hotel. And then find the torch. And then find a campfire to light the torch. And then go find a stadium. And then light an even bigger torch. Man, I'm impressed. They actually managed to come up with a goal that was somewhat challenging and complicated. Certainly an improvement from the other 2 games. What you get for all of that? The torch itself. Yay! Oh yeah, and the other thing. You get something. I don't know. I genuinely don't care anymore. So, that's the Summer Games. Yeah, that's really it. Pretty underwhelming if you ask me. At this point, I'm pretty sure the only reason these events still exist is to get some random lucky developer some sweet, sweet revenue. You can immediately notice how the amount of players in these games went down immensely after the event ended. Enough of my conspiracy theory though, let me know in the comments below what you thought of this event, even though I could care less. It's just a standard YouTuber thing to do to say that.